Family, all of you know the importance of private worship. We know the importance of corporate worship, family worship, and the need for us to worship God as individuals. Now, our church staff wanted to develop a strategy about how we could read God's word well in the new year. And all of you have now have that handout, and if you don't, you can download it from our website. But I wanted to take a moment and kind of just explain why we decided to read Luke, Acts, and Proverbs in this initial Bible reading plan. First, there's an immensely practical purpose. I wanted to get us to Holy Week, because after Holy Week, I'm going to start preaching the book of Matthew, and then we're going to have a different schedule. We're going to read the book of Matthew and lots of Old Testament background. So I needed something to get us to Holy Week. Now, we also should be aware that Luke and Acts are actually two volumes of one set. Luke is the author of both. He writes the books to the same person, Theophilus, for the same purpose, so that he might have assurance that what he's been taught is accurate. The purpose is that people might have assurance and that the lost might get saved. Now, when we look at the book of Luke and Acts, we see a more specific point that salvation is for all people. So there's a practical reason why we're reading these books, but then there's also an important theological purpose. I want us to read these books, and I want us to see our ministry as we take the gospel to the ends of the earth as a continuation of the ministry of Jesus and of our church fathers, the apostles and the disciples. So when we look at the book of Luke, for example, we see that Luke traces Jesus' ministry from Galilee to Judea to Jerusalem. And we see his emphasis is clearly on the Gentiles and the Samaritans. He is the author who gives us the parable of the Good Samaritan. When Jesus cleanses the 10 lepers, the one that comes back is a Samaritan. The genealogy in Luke takes us all the way back to Adam. The genealogy in Matthew takes us back to Abraham. Luke's clear point is that the gospel is for all peoples. We see this in how he emphasizes and highlights certain facts that the other gospel writers don't always bring out. And we see this in the structure. Jesus's ministry is from Galilee all the way to Jerusalem. Now, when we look at the book of Acts, we see the same thing. Acts 1:8 says we're to be Jesus' witnesses from Galilee, from Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. And the book of Acts is structured similarly. We see in the first six chapters God's ministry, the people's ministry in Jerusalem, and then the expansion of the ministry to Judea and Galilee and Samaria, and then it goes all the way to the ends of this earth, to the ends of the earth, with Rome in Acts 28. Now, church family, the gospel in the book of Acts had not yet gone to America, or Upland, or Mexico, or Nicaragua, or Pakistan. That territory is for us to take the gospel to. So my hope is that as we read Luke and Acts, we would see our work as a continuation of the work of Christ and the apostles and the disciples, and that we would be encouraged to continue our mission's emphasis to the ends of this earth. We also are choosing Proverbs because wisdom is not optional, and we need wisdom. When you look in the book of Proverbs, you see that the righteous are wise, the foolish are unrighteous, that it's the wise who inherit the blessings. The foolish are cursed. We see that if you want to treat one another in truly human ways, you have to be wise. Therefore, if you want to be faithful in your relationship to God, you have to be wise. This is a season where we need wisdom. So church family, as we read Luke, Acts, and Proverbs, I hope that these books transform us remarkably for God's glory and our joy, for the sake of the mission, and for the sake of us becoming more wise. Let's join this effort together, church family. Let me encourage you to read along with us as we do this Bible reading plan into Holy Week.